Hello guys, Kepi Shamino here with a new video for you both. And in this video I'm going to show you guys how you need to work with your crew. So I'm going to show you guys everything. So how do you recruit them, how do you level up, where do you need to post them. All the info that I got, it took me some time, 3 days. Do I know everything about it? I don't know. I think I'm coming very close. But first of all, what I want to say to you guys is it's very overwhelming, I can understand it, but it starts very easy. You got officers, under those officers you got sailors that help the officers, but at some point it's always the same that you need to do. So you need to change if you want to torpedo a ship or something, then you need to change your tactic a little bit. But just with controlling your U-boat, it's most of the time just the same. So we are going to start. So first of all, you got 5 officers. I got now 6 officers. Why? Because you can take something very cool in this game. And you go here to the leading officer. So if you take this, I would like to ask you for a few favors. Then you can unlock with reputation. Reputation you are going to get if you do quests. To get 6 officers at board, I got now 6 or 7. 7 is the maximum, I think, according to this. That's how you unlock more officers. More officers on the ship is very handy, because then you can do more tasks at the same moment. So therefore I got 6, and the next time that I can unlock this. I'm not sure how I can unlock this. I think I need to achieve something, because it's locked and you cannot unlock it with reputation points. So that's how you do it. Another thing, how do you recruit your officers and sailors? You just go here to recruitment. And here you can see the files. So you got 4 kinds of officers. You got radio officer. You got a captain officer. No, this is just a sailor, a captain officer. You got an engineer officer and you got a leader officer. So this is the leader. This is the radio man. I cannot recruit now an engineer. So that's it. So you start with 5 officers that you can get on your boat. And you can get 18 sailors on your boat too, just to help the officers. So where can you just get the crew? That's here. So here you can see what I got. So I got now KP Shamino, that's the captain, that's me. You can change the name indeed, so that's very cool. This number, the two, is the level. So you can level them up to, every time that you level them up, you're going to unlock new perks that you can take. So it's a very cool system. I like it a lot. The working around with the crew. Then you got here the West, Felix West. He's an engineer and I got a second engineer too. So I will show you guys now why I got that set up, because you need it. You can have 18 sailors, so I can take one more. Is it always needed to get the full boat? I don't think so, because you don't need to help the whole time with the officers. So I think you can go with 15 or 13. Sometimes it's even easier, because most of the time the sailors are just standing in the way the whole time. So now my crew is ready, and now it's time to do a little bit an overview about the boat. So you got in the boat, you're going to get like a lot of points that you can use. It's very overwhelming, but I'm going to do step by step and I'm going down. So that's the easiest part that we can do. So first of all, if you want to see the management of all your officers, you just need to push tab. So here you see it. So Felix West is, that's all what he did. So he's warming up the torpedoes, he play card, he listened to the radio. I think if you click on it, you can let him do it. But at the moment, he's not doing it. So here you can see the management, what all those guys did. So just tap. If you by accident push N, that means that you just get rid of your officer. Just push N again. I already got it a couple of times, because I'm playing Azerty and N and M are just near each other. And M is map. So now I discovered how you need to do it. So you cannot click anything before you click like an officer. If you click on an officer, you will see that all the stuff that he can click is becoming active. So if you got this and you think, yeah, I cannot not do it. I think I cannot unclick this dude. And you cannot click stuff anymore in your ship. Just click on officer and it will be active. So now we are going into depth for the engineer. So, and it's going to be the same for all four officer classes. So if you click now on West, you will see right away that he got here like his title. He's chief engineer. And all the classes, they can have different titles, but you need to watch it that you know what they do automatically. So why did I make this dude chief engineer? So if you hover over it, you will see it. So the chief engineer will be the first to deal with repairs on your ship. So that's if you get bombed by a ship or bombed by an aircraft, he will start repairing right away in auto mode. When everything works as it should, he will maintain the diesel engine, increasing their maximum speed. So you always need to be sure that West is on the diesel engine. So you just come here. Yeah, and where is my wheel, by the way? Ah, here it is. So you just click on it, and then you are going to assign it. Now, at the moment, West is already on the diesel engine, so that's good. You guys can see it, work diesel engine. And you can add helpers. So the helpers are very important. How can you see what the helpers do? You just hover here over this icon. Come on, game, work a little bit with me. If you want. Yeah, here we go. So you will see what it's going to give if you put an officer on it. So I'm going to unlock forward 4 and 3. Then for every additional sailor that you put with him. So one sailor is 10% less fuel usage and 30% with two sailors. So very important that you know that, guys. So always put helpers on it. Because if you go now here to the speed, you guys will see I got now forward 5. If you let Wesp doing something else, so we can click now on Wesp again, Wesp, and you just let them do this for a brief moment, you will see that my forward 4 and 5 are gone. So here you can see it really easy, so be sure that is always assigned to the diesel engines. So that's it for the chief engineer. So West is now okay, so he's going to repair, he's going to take control of the motors. Sometimes he switched automatically to electric motors too, and yeah, that's okay. So the next step that we are going to do is the radio officers, very important too. So here is the area for the radio officers. So you got the listening room. So that's over here. If you want info, you just right click on it and you just take info. So they are listening with hydrophones. What are hydrophones? They are going to detect the enemies. So be sure that you always got one radio officer on this one and one on the radio room. What is the radio room? It's very easy. It's just the messages that are coming in. Most of the time from headquarters. So that's how you do it. So you need to have two radio guys. So I got two radio guys. But of course, if you click on this one, this was a hydrophone dude. You can go right away to these two. And you will see that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 things they can do. They are a medic too. For the medic, you don't need to do anything. So if somebody is injured, you just right click on it. Take the medic kit and they will do it. So you... I think you only can do it with this guy. So be sure that you know that. So he can be a medic too. Very important if you get bumped. Otherwise people are going to die. They get in panic, those sailors. They start to kill and eat and become zombies and all that shit. So be sure that you can cure them before they become a zombie. So this dude is... I need to think for a moment. Technician officer. So if you hover over technician officer, operates equipment such as hydrophone, sonar or radar detector. So he's perfect for the listening room. So you just click on it. I'm not sure that it's now working. Yeah, it seems to work. So you can just assign him. He got helpers too. So if you want to check what the helpers are doing. So one sailor detection range increases by 25%. So the other dude is another radio dude. It's Smith. So he's going to be a radio officer. Very logic, because he's doing the radio. So that's another thing. So now the radio is complete, and I just remember something. I forgot to say the second engineer. So sorry for that, but we are going back to the engineers because the radio dudes are now okay. You need to have the hydrophone too if you are playing with the torpedoes. So they are going to fix the target. That's one of the things that you need to be active. So this guy, but that's going to be another video. I'm just saying it in front. So another thing, I totally forgot about it. We got Loris too. Loris is a mechanic. Because I like a guy that is always warming up my torpedoes, that my torpedoes are ready. So if I see an enemy and I got a shot on him, I want to shoot. I don't want to wait. So once again, this is an engineer, but he's a mechanic. So most of the time, the mechanic is occupied with loading and preheating torpedoes. But if the ship is damaged, he will stop this and start repairs. So be sure that you got this guy too. So that's the second repair guy. I'm hovering over it. I think if you put guys with him, they are just going to help with him. It's not faster. Yeah, I think it's faster, of course, because they need to load it out and back in. But always be sure that you got them. So, that are the radio guys. That are the engineers. So, that's how we need to do it. Now, we are going to the section, the leaders. So, you got two kind of leaders. You got one captain. You only can get one captain. That's me, KP Shamino. And you got one leader. That's another guy. What is the main purpose of the leader? So first of all, a leader is very important to navigate. Because if you don't have navigation, at some point your ship is off the map. What is going to happen? You're going to hit something and you're stuck. Because you're cruising blindly. So very important that you got a leader on this section. Navigator station, so you just click on this, you just assign, and now this dude is going to do that. Another very important thing with the leaders is they are very important with aiming the torpedoes. So we had the hydrophone radio man, but here is a periscope, here is an attack periscope, and here at the top is the targeting site. Very important. Most of the time you put your leader on it. Here you got a gun for the aircraft. And here you got a gun for the ships. If they are not destroyed yet. Your leaders are going to do that. So they are very important in the aiming process of your torpedoes. So that's just something I'm saying in front. I'm not going to show you guys. That's something for another video. How you need to manual shoot torpedoes. So now this guy is going to navigate the whole time. Normally he's doing it automatically too, because of course you can go once again here to this. So unassigned watch officer, chief boatswain, quartermaster, and they can be medic too. So this guy can cure the injured too. So if you go now over chief boatswain, he's handling the crew issues, and when this is not necessary, he will help with navigation. So he's going to do automatically, normally, the navigation. Okay, so he's now at the right spot. Then for the captain, that's me. He's watch officer. So let's have a look. The watch officer will always try to operate the best observation post available. He will also try to deal with navigation when possible. Therefore, I'm saying that navigation is very important if you don't have enemies, of course. So now we got everything ready. So we get the maximum speed from our engines. We got the whole time torpedoes ready. We got the navigation sorted out. And that's all what you need to have. So it, of course, it's going to change if you get hit, because you need to cure the injured. If you attack ships, it's going to change too. Not a lot, but that's what you need to do. So that's it a little bit, guys. Maybe I can say to end the video. So always be sure that you got in your galley enough food. You can do it with the cook, I think. Can I click on this? Do it? No, it seems I cannot do it with the cook. So I guess I needed to do with an officer too. So be sure that you take an officer, so a leader. Then you take a galley. So storeroom, and that you put enough food in the galley, but it's in the tutorial too. Now I'm going to talk to end the video. I'm going to talk a little bit about leveling because I didn't say anything about leveling. So you can level them too, and that's really cool. So if you just click here, let's check KP Shamino, and you click here on the character screen. So you can see that I'm level 2. So if I go to the skills, I unlocked those two skills. So what do you want? Do you want to become a gunner, or do you want to, see 25% faster with the periscope? That depends. If you want to, I always try to avoid airplanes because they are doing too much damage for the benefit that I get from it. So I would say that I'm going to invest in this. Why? Because I want to search ships and I want to destroy them. So you guys can see it, level 3, 4, 5, 6. So there is still a lot of stuff to learn. So that's what I'm saying. It starts very easy with a couple of officers, but if you go more into depth, you need to watch it because my second officer, it's a little bit silly that I take just the same than my other officer. So I would take a gunner more on my other officer. So my other officer leader, I need to say. So be sure that you think about it because you cannot change it anymore. Then customize. So you can change the name here, voice, shirt, everything you can change. Eye color. You can change face type. So everything you can change. I'm not sure what promotion is. I don't know what it is because I never got it. I guess that you can promote maybe a sailor to an officer or something. I don't know. But that's what you need to do, guys. So a little bit recap. So it's not that that complicated. So two engineers I got, two radio guys I got, two leaders I got. The engineers, diesel motor, they repair torpedoes. Radio guys get the messages from headquarters, detect enemies. That you can bomb them. Torpedo aiming, that's what they are doing too. Then the leaders, most of the time just navigation, that you don't get lost. Sometimes if you want to attack, they go to the periscope to aim. The more aimers that you got, the faster it goes and the better it goes. And that's it a little bit, guys. So don't forget to level them up. Take the right skills, and that was it for this video, guys. I hope it's a little bit clear because it took me some time. At the start, I was like, what the fuck is this? All those guys, they are doing like it looks also random, but the main problem was now it's a little bit better, but at the start, it was very buggy too. So now it's a little bit better. Remember NM. If you push N by accident, don't get crazy in the head, push N again because everything comes back. Okay, thanks for watching, guys. Have fun. I see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.